As part of our Future Makers program, we took on a challenge for 5 days, hiking journey. Day one, there was a lot of preparation that we had to do before we had left the Bogong outdoor school. We all had to sort our own clothing and equipment for outdoor Bogong school, such as tents, sleeping bags, and to pack them away. Plus, all the importance of foods, of course. Finally, we were ready and got our backpacks loaded and ourselves on the bus and headed around the starting place, Camp Creek Gap. We had also worked on planning to have some strategies ready for the time we felt challenged or out of our comfort zone. Each of us had also set a personal goal.
When we were all ready, we got hiking up the Estdale Spur track. The track led straight up and was really tough for most of us. We needed a lot of breaks to catch our breath, and it was very hard and slow hiking. Along the way, the trees got shorter and changed to only being the snow gum. We could see Mount Bogong in the distance, and it seemed like a long way up to the top. There was even snow visible. Finally, we arrived at our campsite, Mitchell Hut. We needed to set up our tents and get organised for our first night out camping on the mountain. Looking upwards, there was definitely still a long way to go. In the hut, we were able to have a great dinner and even made some notes in our journals. I think people are going pretty good, encouraging the people that weren't as quick as the front and, yeah, just helping them out and giving them good feedback. It was pretty cool getting up here and like a sense of accomplishment on the journey, getting the first leg of the way and learning how to set up all our tents and get organised with cooking and just the group that we've got.
Day two. The sun rising woke us up and we were very glad to see the blue skies and sunny weather greeting us. We needed to pack up our bags before we started in on breakfast and cleaning up the hut before we were ready to start hiking up the rest of Eskdale Spur track. Fitting everything in our packs is still a challenge. Don't forget the group equipment. Some of us needed to tape our feet in order to prevent blisters from starting up. Each day we were swapping around the different roles in the group, such as food, navigation, water, and being leaders. The temperatures were pretty cold to start with, but the steep trail and our heavy packs soon got us warmed up. About half an hour up the Eskdale Spur, the snow gums started getting really small and eventually disappeared. This was because of the cold temperatures, which make it impossible for them to grow at this altitude. We were really getting up there now. The views across the mountains were totally spectacular, and they seemed to go onwards forever. We could actually see all the way to the New South Wales mountains and Mount Kosciuszko in the far distance. Trekking up the steep and rocky trail was really tough, and we took it pretty slow, stopping quite a lot to snack and to take in the amazing view. We needed to work together to make it, with some of us encouraging others quite a bit. Soon we were up at the snow level, and it was actually quite slippery to try to walk through. Luckily, it was only patches of snow, and we could avoid walking through it too much. It was a real pleasure to sit at the top of the track and enjoy the views and chuck a few snowballs. After a snack at the very top of Eskdale Spur, we went on to the summit of Mount Bogong. We were the highest people in the whole of Victoria. There we had the highest lunch in the state and stopped for a few group photos in the sunshine. we needed to walk onwards towards the west peak of Mount Bogong. It was still about 5 kilometres away, and it was a long afternoon of hiking across the summit ridgeline to get into the west peak area. All along the way, the views of the mountains were all around us. Our packs were still heavy, and there was a light breeze which kept things cool. Today was one of the biggest days of walking, and it was tough to keep going and climb the last steep part of West Peak. We passed through Stirling Gap and onwards to the summit of West Peak, which was our campsite for the night. Being on West Peak felt like having the world at our feet. We could see far out towards the Kiwa Valley, Mount Buffalo, and all the way towards Beechworth and home. Being up there camping and watching the sunset was one of the biggest highlights of the hike journey. As the sun set, it started to get pretty cold, so after we ate dinner, we were all into bed pretty quick. In fact, some of us were sleeping by 7 o'clock that night, which has to be some kind of record.
The morning was cold and foggy, and for about an hour we could only see inside of clouds. As we packed up our tents again and got our backpacks loaded up, back up. But during breakfast, the clouds started to lift and we could see amazing views off of Mount Bogong in the morning sunshine. Walking off the West Peak was a challenge in the fog, and for a short time we started to walk off the wrong way. Luckily, we were able to get back on the track. Our hiking route took us along the main ridge of Mount Bogong and down again into the Snow Gums levels. Not far down the track was our campsite, Cleve Call Hut. It was great to arrive at the hut and eat some lunch and relax and enjoy the afternoon. It felt like luxury after the 2 past days of hiking. A few of us decided to do an extra walk out to a spectacular Hellman's Falls. This was about 2 kilometres downhill from the hut, along a beautiful alpine valley. It was a great view past the falls. Each day we wrote a bit in our journals and did some reflection about the day.
Day 4. We had a pretty chilled out morning at our campsite to start the day. In fact, we actually ate lunch before we got going. Packing up the tents seemed easier today because we were more used to how everything works, but we still had a challenge finding people to carry the group equipment. We left Cleve Call Hut and climbed back up the mountain onto the ridgeline above the trees. We predicted it would take 2.5 hours to get to Michelle's hut, but we actually got there much faster, probably because it was downhill. The views were great. We stopped at one spot just to look at the view and be a bit mindful of everything that has happened over the past few days.
Just looking out over the mountains into the distance, and the sky seems so big. Back at the hut, it was pretty familiar now, and we were just relaxed and enjoyed having soup and snacks in the afternoon sun. It was a pretty different feeling to last time we were here.
Day 5. Right on dawn, the wind and rain arrived and we woke up to the foggy and wet day. The tents were totally saturated and the ground was muddy.
By your side, but now that is over.
We packed up inside our tents and then got our tents down as fast as possible. At least now we can do the packing up of the packs pretty well. We were fortunate to have the hut there to shelter in during breakfast as the rain continued to fall harder. It felt like a good day to be heading home. Even though it was raining, our spirits were high. The track ahead us was mostly downhill, and at the end of it was the bus and our destination for the day, the outdoor school at Bogong Village. We walked back down into the mountain forest, stuck together as a group as we went. The track was pretty slippery too. Arriving back at the bus was a great feeling. We had completed the hike and everyone had done really well. Overall, the Future Maker hike has been an amazing experience, and we all feel grateful for being able to visit and enjoy Mount Bogong for the past 5 days.